back to another haul video. For the start of this haul, I'm going to show you the Kelly Perky kit that I recently picked up. It is not a subscription kit. It's a kit that she does every month, and you can just pick it up without a subscription. So it's really great. If one month you don't want it, you don't have to get it. And the cards are super stinking cute. This is not necessarily my favorite card color scheme that she's done, but I really loved the stamp set itself, and I do love some of the different cards that come with it and the flair that come with it. And it is on the pricier side for a kit, but to me it's just worth it because I normally really love the stamp sets. I don't get it every month, I just get it whenever it's a stamp set that I just have to have. So I'm just showing you guys all the different cards that it comes with it, and they all are double-sided, so you can kind of use them in different ways, which is great. And this haul is a mishmash of stuff, you guys, so just bear with me. I'm going to try to make sure I remember everywhere that I've gotten all this stuff, and I'll be sure to try to put links to everything of where I got it, or at least the store that I picked it up, because I usually don't do individual links, but I'll let you know which store I picked it up at or whatnot. I loved this stamp set because if you have any traveling pictures or things like that, the stamp set is kind of like perfect for those type of pictures. And there's a few Project Life layouts that I still need to do for some pictures I have from when I went to California and such, so I had to get that. Then I picked up this container at Michael's because they were having a sale off their containers. I already had this one where I keep all my little like acrylics slash special embellishments, and they have that little plastic dividers that divide each section, which is really great, so you can kind of customize them and make them bigger or smaller depending on how much you have of one item. So I really love that to stay organized, so I got another one for my wood veneers. That way I can just kind of organize a little bit more, because even though I have one thing that I keep them in already, I want to have a special separate place to keep all my like custom wood veneers. And then I also picked this up at Michael's, and it was in their little dollar section, and I just loved it because it's like pink and white, and the little leopard print clipboard it comes on is super duper cute, and it was like a dollar, I believe. And I also picked that up at Michael's, which I thought I could use in my Filofax or planner, or even just put it on my fridge because I love plaid and craft. So yeah, just two random little items that I just had to have. And then from Joann's, I picked up this vellum paper pad, which y'all know I'm obsessed with vellum and gold foiling. And this pad combined both of those, so it has like cute striped gold foiling, it has little stars, hearts in gold foil, not every page is gold foil as you can see, dots in gold foil, some random patterns, some polka dots, gold chevron, but it just comes with a lot of pretty papers, so I thought it was worth it, and it was on a 40% off, so I had to pick it up, you guys. And then I picked up this Heidi Swap Alpha because the letters are actually like a medium size, so they're kind of perfect to use for Project Life for title cards and such. And they have that cool resist with a stripiness on them, but you can't really see that on camera. But you guys will see it when I use it in my actual Project Life spreads. And then I picked up this stamp set because my craft friend Jill enabled me and was just like, I want that. And then I saw it and I was like, you know, I'm just going to give in and get it because it's a good deal. I really like the font. Heidi has beautiful handwriting and also the stencil. So I decided to pick it up, so I can't wait to use that on something in the near future. And then I picked up these neon brads because I'm obsessed with neon colors, and I just thought these are super cute, and I totally plan on using them on a future spread with to put some pop of color. And then this cute little owl, even though I'm not buying any more wood stamps, but that and the like were just too cute to pass up, and the thumbs up, so I had to get them. They're like perfect for Facebook pictures etiquette and all that stuff. And then I picked up this punch, which is a 3x3 inch square. I picked it up to actually put in my snap pockets that they have, those 2x2 snap pockets that are like really tiny sections. And I did buy a smaller punch originally, but it did not fit it quite as snug as this one did, so I liked this one better. And then I picked up this scraper for doing art projects such as molding paste and all of that. So I will be using that in the future, and that was also at Michael's. And then I also picked up this Ellie Studio stamp set. It was one of their limited edition fall stamp sets, and I believe it's still available. And it's just so cute. I saw so many possibilities with this that I had to just kind of stamp one of my favorite stamps from that set out for you guys, so you guys can kind of see what I'm talking about. It just says a blank day, and I love how the little scallops underneath look. And the great thing about it is not only could you stamp something in between the A and a day, but you could also write something in between there if you have nice handwriting or you like to do your own kind of like scripty stuff. So I decided to just kind of put something in between there just to show you guys like what a cute thing you could do with it. Like, how cute is that? So I'm really looking forward to using that in my Project Life. And it's a good Thanksgiving type stamp. And then I also picked up this stamp set, and this was from either the Scrapyard or another one of the groups that I'm in, which y'all know, most of you guys who follow me probably are in those groups. And I wanted that for that pie chart that I've wanted forever, and it's super cute and has all these little things you can stamp within, so yeah. And then next, I picked up these Allie Edwards stamps, which I'm kind of obsessed with the stamps that she's been coming out with, so I kind of had to get them. I was lucky enough to be able to snag these, so I'm feeling really blessed because when I saw them, I loved them so much, but, you know, I couldn't really justify getting the kit because I didn't love everything in the kit, not to mention it was a little bit pricey for me right now, so I was actually able to get all of these separately, which is great because it cut down the cost for me, so yay! And then I got these screen prints as well, and I've been dying to try out the screen prints. I was finally able to get these, which was from last month's Studio Calico Project Life Kit. I didn't get the kit, but I was able to snag the stencils, thankfully. Some people made my day, and I got them from two different people, I believe also in another group. And it's kind of like a stencil, except I feel like it might even be better because it's got that sticky side to it. I'll let you guys know, and I'll probably do it on camera if that's something you guys are interested in seeing, me using these and seeing what you can do with them. If it is, leave me a comment or like this video. I love to know what you guys want to see because I also want to do videos that you guys want to see something of. And then I also picked up this stamp set, which I thought was great for fall and December because it has cute little icons like a deer and a maple leaf, and it's just super cute in general. I love it. And then I also got this washi tape from Studio Calico's last month's kit, and one of my crafty friends was sweet enough to throw that in there for me when I got some things from her, so she's awesome, and that was very, very kind of her to do, so I got lucky this month. I was so happy with those. It made my day. And then I also picked up this Gossamer Blue stamp set, which I also just got the stamp set, not the actual kit, because I really wanted the stamp set, and I really just thought that I could do so many things with it, so I was so excited to get that. And then I also picked up two of these alphas, which I think are Echo Park. I'm not sure. I think they are, though. And I loved that they had these multiple colors, because you guys know I'm obsessed with these little mini alphas for Project Life. They're perfect for creating title cards. And then look at this beauty. I picked up this handbook, which is basically a 6x8 handbook. I've been wanting to do, maybe, possibly, do smaller Project Life albums in the future for like a mini event like December Daily or 30 Days of Thankful. So that's something I'm considering doing. If you guys are also interested in me doing kind of like a series on December Daily or 30 Days of Thankful, let me know, because then maybe I'll consider doing that if I have the time to. But either way, I'm saving this handbook for something really special because I love it. And I love that it has room to grow, even though it has a little strappy. You could definitely fill this guy up. So I'm excited, and we'll see how I end up using it. But when I saw this, I needed to have it, so hopefully I will be using that in the near future. Then I was lucky enough to catch the Freckled Fawn Warehouse sale. I don't subscribe to Freckled Fawn's kit, but not because I don't want to, but because I don't have the money to. But their products are awesome. And I picked up these two arrow stickers. They were $1 each. Normally, I believe they're $1.99 or $2.99. Picked up these Daisy Brads, and I love all things kind of retro slash 70s looking, so I really wanted these because I just thought they were super cute. Then I also picked up a set of acrylic pieces. I currently have a partial set of these arrows, but I wanted to get another one because these were on sale for $1 and I really loved them and I kept wanting to hoard them. So now that I have another set, I can feel a little bit better about using those. Then I also picked up an extra sticker sheet because you guys know I love these stickers. I also picked up this little metal these little metal wreaths that literally are so cute and delicate, and they come in black and white, and I just had to have them. I remember when they were in a kit of theirs, and I was just dying to have some, so I got to get some, and they were $1 for all four of these, so yay me! And then I picked up these wood veneer Polaroid type frames, and I really love that you get the actual letters from the cutouts as well. And now on to my resin grab bag. This grab bag was $7. I didn't know what was going to come in it, so I was really hoping it was going to be worth the value, and I do believe that it is. I got that set of cute flares, as well as another set of two cute flares that was packaged individually, and these are super cute. And I don't use a ton of flare on my layouts, but I hope to in the future. I just think sometimes when I'm creating a layout, I don't think to use it because since I'm not quite used to it, it just doesn't cross my mind and I forget about them. But I totally plan on using more flare in the future. This square flare is super cute. I've never had a square flare. And it also came with that little ice cream one you saw behind it, as well as this cake one and this super cute little like navy or black balloon. And then another set of flair as well. And this just said like lovely and hello. And they're super cute. I think just the amount of flair alone is probably worth at least $7. So I really feel like it's a good budget or a good deal. I got these cute little prezzies that are made out of acrylic. And I think those will be good for December or a card. And then I got these kind of like little cross, little resin pieces as well, and these are my favorite resin pieces I got. They're little speech bubbles with hearts in them with glitter as well, and a cute little strawberry. I'm obsessed with these. I love them, and hopefully I will use them in the layout and not try to hoard them. So that's pretty much what I got for the resin. And then this is the wood veneer grab bag, which was $7 as well. First I got these cute little wooden tickets, which you could totally stamp or even watercolor on. They're super cute, so I can't wait to use those. I got another set of the Polaroid, but these have different sayings than the other set I showed you guys, and they also come with the little letter cutouts, which is super cute. It's like getting some alpha as well as the Polaroid itself. I also got these little banners. I didn't know it was going to come in this grab bag either, so all this stuff is really random. I love these too, and so I'm just like, I have a bunch of wood I can play with now. These huge numbers, which are like the size of my palm basically, and I believe they were from last year's December kit, so I'm really excited to have these and to be able to use them. So I'm sure I'll be doing something with those. And then I also got a packet of these little Tweety birds with the little musical notes. And this pack alone is like, I believe, like $3 or $4. So just that alone made this grab bag worth it. And then I got these little emoji wood veneers. You guys know how much I love the happy faces. So I'm so excited that I got these because I had wanted these anyway. So this grab bag actually was an awesome deal, and I'm so happy I was able to snag one. I hope you guys were able to get some too. And then I also got some washi. I got this label washi, which I had wanted for a while, and it was on sale for about $2. I believe it's normally like $2.99. I'm not sure if it's more than that, but I think that's what it was. And I love this because it's going to be perfect for Project Life and as well for my Filofax or planner. And then I got this yellow one that has sayings on it like smile and different things like perfect day. It's just really pretty, and I love the color yellow that it is. I love different tones of yellows, so I think it's just gonna be perfect for anywhere I want to put it pretty much. And I believe I got that roll for $1. And also, if you guys get a chance and you got some grab bags and you don't have a YouTube or whatever, be sure to follow me on Instagram and maybe tag me to show me what you guys got in your grab bag in case you got something different than what I got. I'd love to see. That was like the heart and striped one. Now this is the light blue one, which I pretty much got just because I loved the color of it. So I thought it'd be great to add little touches of that to different cards to give a touch of blue. It's like a kind of like a Tiffany blue. It's really pretty, and I got it for more for the color than for the dates. Even though I think the dates is cool too. I got this pink stripe and gold one. I believe this one was $2, and I have this roll already actually, and I originally paid like $5 for the roll, so it was a really great deal. So I just decided to pick up another one, whether or not I end up giving it away or something. And then I got this baby blue striped one, which was super cute too. And it's funny because it comes on a plastic roll. I never really noticed that some washi comes on a plastic roll and some comes on paper. I just thought it all came on paper rolls. And I just thought it was cute, and it's kind of a thinner washi, so I definitely know I'll get use out of that. And this roll, I don't know what this pattern is, but I thought it was really pretty colors and totally up my alley, so I got it as well. And then I picked up this one, which I've named the Great Gatsby roll, because to me the gold and the black together like this with the details of the washi really remind me of the design from that movie. And you cannot see through this, so I wonder exactly what I'll be using this on, but I just thought it was really cute, so I just had to get it. And then I got this cloud washi as well, which I'm actually totally obsessed with. I think it's so cute, and I love how it's see-through on the cloud part, so if you put it on paper, you could totally see the pattern of the paper behind it, and it's just adorable. Like, I'd wanted this one for a while, so I'm happy I was able to snag that as well. And then this pattern, I really wasn't sure if I was gonna like it, but I was like, you know, it's $1 and I kinda do like the colors, but I actually like it more in person than I did on the actual site. So I am really happy that I got it. It's got a, like kind of like a color blocking effect to it, and it's just really pretty. So I do see myself using that in the future as well. And then I got this kind of like striped gray and orange and a fuchsia pink type one, with yellow and orange, and it's just really pretty, and I like how the colors all go together, and you could easily use this like on several layouts. Last but definitely not least is my Instax Share printer. I really wanted this for a while, so I ended up getting it. I'm going to be doing a video on how I use this, how to use it. If you guys want to see that, be sure to like this video and leave me a comment. I'm so excited to share this with you guys, and I actually sold my Hello Kitty Instax in order to get this, to put the money towards it, so I cannot wait to see what I'm going to be able to do with this in combination with Project Life. So if you guys want to see videos on that type of stuff, be sure to let me know. And thank you guys so much for watching. I totally appreciate your support and for everything and all the love and comments you guys always give me. Thanks so much for watching. Bye guys.